Hi, I'm Pete. Thanks for joining me today. I'm going to be showing you how to make a delicious stovetop pot roast for beginners. There's nothing better than on a cold winter day to get a pot roast going and smell it cooking all day long. It's heaven.
You have your roast beef. I don't rinse mine, but some people do. I've lived to tell about it.
Poke holes in your chuck roast with a butter knife and put some garlic in each one of those holes.
I know some of you young people don't remember that song, Rub It In, Rub It In. Woohoo! That was risque back in my time. And it doesn't make it hot or anything like that. Now, flour all sides. Wash your hands real good and then get your Dutch oven out. Put a little bit of oil in it and you're going to fry it, brown it really good on both sides. And if you can flip it over like that to brown it on those edges, that would be good too.
It says by putting a little flour in it, you can see it sizzling. May or may not be hot enough, but we're going to see. Gently lower your roast. Oh yeah, hear that sizzle? Gently lower your roast down into a grease. Don't burn yourself.
Once it's browned really good on the bottom, turn it over, flip it over, and keep browning.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, baby. That's how it's supposed to look right there. Doing the edges. What was that?
After you've browned all sides of the roast, this is when you would want to spoon out any excess grease that's in there, but leave 1 to 2 tablespoons for gravy. Add just enough water to go halfway up the side of the roast. Do not completely cover the roast with water, just enough to simmer. In about an hour, to the top of the roast, add 1 to 3 bay leaves, depending on how big they are, and a big slice of onion. Then put the lid back on and continue simmering for 3.5 hours.
So after about 3.5 hours into the simmering, you'll want to prepare your potatoes, wash them, and just kind of peel them like that. The peelings help the potatoes keep from breaking apart. If you have really big potatoes, though, you might want to cut them in half and do that. This is just, and get your carrots ready. If you have a really extra thick carrot, cut it in half. You're going to put your carrots on top and you're going to put your potatoes all around the roast. Sometimes you kind of lift the roast up and kind of finagle your potatoes in there. Then you cook it for about another hour, hour and a half, until where they're tender.
Once the potatoes and carrots are fork tender, it's time to take them out. Before you take your carrots and potatoes up, you might want to throw some garlic salt on the carrots. Once you've removed your roast to a platter or a pan, that's when I salt the top of it. Salt it fairly good, but not too much, and then cover it with foil to keep it warm. If you didn't use garlic in the beginning of it, the minced garlic, you can use garlic salt on top of your roast instead. Bay leaves are not edible, so be sure and take them out and throw them away. You can use the broth as is for gravy, or you can thicken it with a flour and water mixture. I like to add about a capful of kitchen bouquet. It helps brown it and give it a little bit more flavor. You don't have to use it. It's good though. boil your gravy for about 5 to 10 minutes to get rid of the floury taste. If the gravy seems a little too thick, just add some more water. Too thin, add some more flour water mixture. It is so, so, so delicious. Thank you for joining me, and catch you next time.